And specifically as an African American man, did race ever come into your mind as a reason why you couldn't do something, or were you ever concerned about being treated differently because of your race?
Roger King, God bless his soul, Roger was probably the most successful syndicator in television. He sold Wheel of Fortune, Jeopardy, and Oprah and to television. He called me up one day and he said, "Hey, I want you to come pitch me." And I just started my company from my dining room table. And I said, "Okay." And I went and I pitched him. Roger King, he says, "Listen up." He goes, "You know, I play golf with all these guys that own and operate these TV stations." And he said, they when I'm playing golf, they talk about how much you call them and how you're trying to sell them your show. And they don't call you back, and they're not gonna call you back, and they're not gonna do business with you because you're black." The most successful guy in television. He said, "I didn't realize how bad it was until I went to sell Oprah and I'm playing golf with these guys and they're joking about not calling you back because you're black." And he said, "I don't like that." He said, "My mother and my daddy raised me better than that. No one has ever been that honest, that open."
Right, straightforward.
Straightforward. Mm-hmm. He goes, "But listen up." He goes, "I'm having my 50th birthday at my beach house." And he says, "Every guy who owns and operates a television station that's worth anything will be at my house on my beach. I want you to come to my party, my beach house. Please be there." And I say, "My name is Byron Allen." And they go, "Oh yeah." They go, "Yeah, you're right here on the list. The boss keeps asking about you. The boss has come out here a couple of times going, where are you?" He goes, "Yeah, he's gonna be happy." So I walk in and, "Hey, Roger." He goes, "Byron Allen!" Whole party can see it. He just wants the whole party to hear this.
Yes.
He goes, "Now we can get this party started." That's what he says. "Because you know why, ladies and gentlemen? We've got the hardest working man in show business here today." And he kind of whispers down to me. He goes, "Who here is not returning your phone calls?" And I kind of looked up at him and I said, "Everybody?"
What were their faces like?
Everybody, like, right? And I'll never forget this. And it was the first, and I was like, really witnessed true power. And he goes, "Yeah, watch this." He goes, hey, "Fred, put down the guacamole and chips. Come talk to me." Now, this is the general manager of a station who would not return 50 phone calls. He says, "Hey, Fred, do you want to renew Wheel of Fortune, Jeopardy, and Oprah? And clearly you had to have these shows. You would lose your career if you didn't renew them." And then he goes, and the guy kind of sheepishly laughs. He goes, "Yeah, of course, Roger, of course." He goes, "Yeah, I know." He goes, "I'm just trying to figure out how much I want to charge you," is what Roger says to the guy. "I'm just trying to figure out what I'm going to make you pay," is what he says to him. He goes, "But while I'm thinking about what I'm going to make you pay, why don't you call Byron back and see what you can do with him? Because I know he's been calling you, and I know he's got a really good show. So why don't you go and figure something out with him? You guys figure something out. And then after you figure something out, you and I will talk about what I'm going to charge you for Wheel of Fortune, Jeopardy, and Oprah." The guy looked at me. He goes, "Byron, I'll call you on Monday."
You damn right he'll call you on Monday.
I said, "Hey, Fred, no problem. Look forward to chatting with you." Boom. I never had any problems ever again. A number of my salespeople, they would come back to me, right? Because they go on the road and I say, "Well, how come you're not getting anything done in that station or that market?" And they would pause and they were embarrassed. And I say, no, don't pause. Like, tell me the truth. I can work with anything. I'm a comedian. I've literally been booed by 100,000 people. I can
nothing
handle
can
it.
Be worse, yeah.
I've been booed off the stage by literally 100,000 people at the Los Angeles Coliseum. I'm good. I can handle it. And he just said, "Well," he says, "you know, the guy said to me, I like you, but I'm not going to do business with you as long as you work for that nigger." And I've heard that from about 4 of my salespeople. And individually, they would tell me stories about how certain people would respond and say, I'm not going to do business with you because of who you work for. And I said, I got it. I said, I'm glad you told me that. Now I know how to deal with it. I just thought you were a horrible salesperson. and I'm relieved you're not a horrible salesperson. I can work with him calling me the N-word. I cannot work with your poor skills. So we can get around that. I was raised, you love people and you respect people and you embrace people and you really look at them and see them for who they are as a human being and as a person.